This is class 10, CBSE, Civics, Chapter 2, Federalism, Part 5. Decentralization in India. That means the transfer of authority from central government and state governments to local government. We noted above that federal governments have two or more tiers of governments. So according to the federal government, there are two or more tiers that we learned already. We have so far discussed the two tiers of government in our country. So previous videos we discussed about the two tiers of government in our country India, that is central government and state government. But a vast country like India cannot be run only through these two tiers. So India is a vast country. So according to the world, India is the seventh largest country. So it's cannot be run only through these two tiers, that is central government and state government. So we need one more level. States in India are large as independent countries of Europe. So most of the states in India, according to the area wise, it's large as countries of Europe. In terms of population, so according to the population, Uttar Pradesh is bigger than Russia. So according to the population, Uttar Pradesh is bigger than Russia. Maharashtra is about big as Germany. So one of the important country in Europe, that is Germany. If we compare Germany with Maharashtra, Maharashtra is the bigger one. Many of these states are internally very diverse. So many of these states internally, they are diverse according to their ethnic, culture, tradition, language, etc. There is thus a need for power sharing within these states. So that's what here, a need for power sharing within these states. Federal power sharing in India needs another tier. So sharing of the power, we need one more tier, that means one more level of government below that of the state governments. So next level from the state government. This is the rationale for decentralization of power. This is the important reasons for decentralization of power. Thus resulted a third tier of government called local government. So that's what it's resulted, one more level of government, that is third tier of government. That one is called as local government or local self-government. When power is taken away from central and state governments and given to local government, it is called decentralization. Important, this is the definition of decentralization. So when the power is taken away, some of the powers from the central and state government and share or given to the local government, that one is known as decentralization. The basic idea behind decentralization is that there are a large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. First one is the for this basic idea, why they started this third tier of government or decentralization, because of there are large number of problems and issues, so which are best settled at the local level itself. This is the first basic idea for the decentralization. Next one is people have better knowledge of problems in their localities. So those who are living in that area, that people know better about that problems and issues. Next one is they also have better ideas on where to spend money and how to manage things more efficiently. So the local peoples themselves have the better ideas. So where they have to spend the money for the improvement of that area, which is basic need for them that time, and how to manage things more efficiently. This one is third one. Next one is, besides at the local level, it is possible for the people to directly participate in decision making. This is most important point, because at the local level, it is highly possible for the general people to directly participate in the decision making process. Next one is, this helps to inculcate. So this is important thing. This one is helps to inculcate or helps to teach a habit of democratic participation from the basic level. This is fifth point. Next one is, local government is the best way to realize one important principle of democracy, namely local self-government. This is very important. So local government is the best way to realize one important principle of democracy, that is local self-government, self-ruling. So they have to analyze their own problems, that local people only know their problems in a better way. They know that how to solve the problems effectively, and also they know in their level how to spend the money, which is the important for them need, then how to manage the things more efficiently. And also important thing is, highly possible for that local people to directly participate in the decision making process. So this one is inculcate, that is this one is teach a habit of democratic participation effectively. The need for decentralization was recognized in our constitution. Decentralization was recognized, they approved through our constitution. Since then, there have been several attempts to decentralize power to the level of villages and towns. So since then, there have been several attempts, several things they did, improvement for many attempts to decentralize the power at the level of villages and towns in that third level. Panchayats in villages and municipalities in urban areas. So the local self-government is subdivided into two, that is rural areas, another one is urban areas. That is, rural areas means villages, urban areas means cities and towns. So villages side, they started the panchayats. Then urban side is known as municipalities. They are set up in all the states, but these were directly under the control of state governments. These panchayats and municipalities were under the control of state governments. Elections to these local governments were not held regularly. Local governments did not have any powers or resources of their own. Thus, there was very little decentralization in effective terms. So, when they accepted to start the decentralization, need of the decentralization also recognized by our constitution. From that time onwards, they did many several attempts for to decentralize, that means sharing of the power to the third level of government. So that one is subdivided into two, villages and towns. So villages are considered as a panchayats, and municipalities in urban areas means towns and cities. They set up all the states, but these third tier were directly under the control of the state governments. Here elections were not held regularly for the panchayat and municipalities, and local governments did not have any pass or resources. Resources means money for their own. They are not allowed to collect any taxes or any resources of their own. Thus, here there was a very little decentralization only was there. A major step towards decentralization was taken in 1992. This is important. So decentralization made effectively and took many major steps by the constitution in 1992. The constitution was amended in 1992. They amended, that means they changed, to make the third tier of democracy more powerful and effective. So in 1992, constitution was amended, constitution was changed to make the third tier more powerful and effective. Here 5 points are there. We'll see that. Now it is constitutionally mandatory. So now it is constitutionally compulsory. Mandatory means compulsory to hold regular elections to local government bodies, that is 5 years once. So 5 years once they should, it's compulsory, it's mandatory to hold regular elections. Seats are reserved. So here they allotted the reservation seats in the elected bodies and the executive heads of these institutions. These institutions mean that panchayat and municipalities, for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribes and other backward classes. That means they allotted the reserved seats for elected members as well as the executive heads for these institutions, for the SC, ST and OBC. At least 1/3, this is important, 1/3 of all positions are reserved for women. So in local self-government, they allotted 1/3 of the reservation seats for women. An independent institution called the State Election Commission. So who is conducting the election means State Election Commission has been created in each state, in each and every state, to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. So an independent institution was set up or created in each state to conduct the regular election in panchayat and municipalities by the State Election Commission. The state governments are required to share some powers and revenue with local government bodies. State governments are required to share some powers and revenue, because previously they didn't do. Now they should do. They have to share some powers to the local self-government as well as the revenue amount with local government bodies. The nature of sharing varies from state to state. So the sharing of the power as well as the revenue, it varies, it different from state to state. Rural local government is popularly known by the name Panchayati Raj. Actually, this local self-government, you already learned in that younger classes, I think so. Even though I will give a review, local self-government is subdivided into two. One is panchayat, another one is municipalities. This Panchayati Raj, once again subdivided into three levels, that is Gram Panchayat, Block or Mandal or Samiti Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti, panchayat samiti, block or mandal. Then upper level is zilla parishad. The gram panchayat members are elected by gram sabha. Gram sabha means a particular village adult peoples, that is voters, those who attained the age 18 years and above, they have the right to vote. These village adult members, that is Gram Sabha members, through the election, they elect the Gram Panchayat members, that means ward members. That members only known as Panch. That members only known as Panch. This group head is known as president or sarpanch. That means head of that ward members. So, the head of the panch. So, sar means head. Sarpanch. This Gram Sabha elected, that is direct, through the direct election, they elect the Gram Panchayat ward members, were known as panch. So the head of the Gram Panchayat is known as president or sarpanch. So the each and every Gram Panchayat together, that means two or three panchayats together, they vote and elect the representatives of the panchayat samiti or block or mandal. So panchayat members only elected the block or mandal members. Then these blocks together and form the higher level, that one is known as zilla parishad. Zilla means district, so district level, so zilla parishad. This zilla parishad head usually a political head. This is the basic structure of the panchayati raj. Now we'll see about the municipalities. Actually, panchayati raj is village level, that is rural level. Municipalities comes under the urban level. So urban areas, local government is municipalities. These municipalities also have subdivided into three levels. Nagar Panchayat, first one is Nagar Panchayat. Then above Nagar Panchayat is Municipal Council or Municipalities. Municipal Council. Then above is Municipal Corporations. Actually, this base is divided according to the size of the area as well as the population and the development of the particular area. Nagar Panchayat means this Nagar is not considered the complete village, it's not considered as a complete town. It is somewhat between that Nagar Panchayat. It's a between that village as well as the town. So this one is known as Nagar Panchayat. This Nagar Panchayat members were elected by the ward members of that particular area. Next level is Municipal Council. Here that particular area, that is town areas, that is municipality areas or township areas, that area's ward members, that area also divided into many wards, that ward members elect their councillors. That is council. The member of the councillors comes under the municipal council. So thus, that ward members elect the municipal council members in that township area level, somewhat bigger level. Then higher level is completely for the big cities, especially that metropolitan cities plus very big large cities, like district capitals, like that type of cities. That cities government only known as municipal corporations. Usually the municipal corporation head is mayor, The municipal corporation head is mayor. The municipal council head is usually the political head. This is the basic structure of the local self-government of rural and urban. Rural local government is popularly known by the name Panchayati Raj. Each village or a group of villages in some states has a Gram Panchayat. So according to the population only, they divide that. If the village has high level of population, that they take it as a each village one Gram Panchayat. If the village has less population, so they combine with the two or three villages together, and for that two or three villages group has one Gram Panchayat. This is a council members, group of members consisting of several ward members. That means the village, that area divided into many wards. So each and every wards, they elect the one members. So that ward members group only known as council. That is grouping of the ward members present in the Gram Panchayat. Often these ward members often called panch and a president or sarpanch. So that head of the ward members is president or sarpanch. They are directly elected by all the adult population living in that ward or village. So here that panch, that is ward members, president or sarpanch, are elected directly by the adult population. That means voters of that particular village, otherwise a particular ward. Okay, they only elected directly. It is the decision making body for the entire village. The Gram Panchayat is the decision making body for that entire village, for that village. The Panchayat works under the overall supervision of the Gram Sabha. So the Gram Panchayat ward members are elected by the Gram Sabha members only, that is adult persons of that village. This Gram Panchayat also works under the supervision of the Gram Sabha. All the voters in the village are its members. So all the voters of that village are the members of the Gram Sabha. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat and to review the performance of the Gram Panchayat. So this Gram Sabha members, usually in a year, per year, they has to meet at least twice or thrice. So per year, two times or three times, they have to meet and approve the annual budget. They discuss in that meeting and they approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat, and also they review, they look back the performance of the Gram Panchayat. They discuss all these things in that meeting. The local government structure goes right up to the district level. Yeah, few Gram Panchayats are grouped. So few Gram Panchayats, like three or four group Gram Panchayats groups together to form what is usually called a Panchayat Samiti or block or mandal. So next above level of that Gram Panchayat is Panchayat Samiti or block or mandal, which is consisting of a group of Gram Panchayat, usually three or four Gram Panchayat groups. The members of this representative body are elected by all the Panchayat members in that area. So the members of this representative body are elected by all the Panchayat members, not by the Gram Sabha members, Panchayat members.
already elected members of that Gram Panchayat. They only elect the representatives of the Panchayat Samiti. All the Panchayat Samitis or Mandals in a district together constitute the Zilla, that is district Parishad, that is Zilla Parishad. So all together the Panchayat Samitis of that particular district together is known as Zilla Parishad. Most members of the Zilla Parishad are elected. So majority of the members of the Zilla Parishad are elected members. Like members of the Lok Sabha, that means MPs of that district, and MLAs of that district, so members of the Lok Sabha and MLAs of that district and some other officials of other district level bodies are also its members. So plus other officials of other district level bodies also member of this Zilla Parishad. Zilla Parishad chairperson is the political head of the Zilla Parishad. Similarly, local government bodies exist for urban areas as well. So, as per the rural local government, similarly, local government body exists for the urban areas also. Municipalities are set up in towns. So, municipalities, they are set up in towns. Big cities are constituted into municipal corporations. So town level municipalities, cities level municipal corporations. Both municipalities and municipal corporations are controlled by elected bodies consisting of people's representatives. So both the municipalities and municipal corporations are controlled by the elected bodies, elected representatives by the peoples, consisting of people's representative. Municipal chairperson is the political head of the municipality. So municipalities chairperson is political head of that particular municipality. In a municipal corporation, such an officer, that is head of the municipal corporation, is called mayor. Here one case study is given here. We'll see this. An experiment in Brazil. Brazil is a important country, one of the important country, which is located in the South America. A city called Porto Alegre in Brazil has carried out an extraordinary experiment in combining decentralization with participative democracy. In Brazil, they carried out one experiment with the combination of decentralization, that means sharing of the powers, along with that participative democracy, that means participation by that people's side, public side. The city has set up a parallel organization operating alongside the municipal council, enabling local inhabitants to take real decisions for their city. So the local peoples, inhabitants means those who are living in that area, they are asked them to participate to take real decisions for their city. The nearly 13 lakh people in this city get to participate in making the budget for their own city. So they have to prepare their budget. The city is divided into many sectors. Like in India, we divided that many towns into wards. Likewise, here they divided into sectors, or what we call here as wards. Each sector has a meeting. So each ward, that means each area sector, has a meeting like that of the Gram Sabha. So how the every village they are conducting the meeting per year twice or thrice like that, in which anyone living in that area can participate. There are some meetings to discuss issues also that affect the entire city. Issues like which is affect that entire city, like a common issues for that all the members, that type of issues they are conducting the meeting and discuss in that. Any citizen of the city can participate. So in that city, any person can participate in those meetings. The budget of the city is discussed in these meetings. The proposals are put to the municipality that takes a final decision about it. So whatever they taken the decisions, so final they made a complete proposal and given to the municipality, they will take the final decision. About 20,000 people participate in this decision making exercise every year. So every year almost 20,000 people participate in the decision making. This method has ensured that the money cannot be spent only for the benefit of the colonies where rich people live. So they only discuss that and prepare the budget. They are ensured that money cannot be spent only for that that particular colonies where the rich people live. Buses now run to the poor colonies, and builders cannot evict slum dwellers without resettling them. The builders cannot expel the people or send away slum dwellers without resettling them, without giving any space or amount to that slum dwellers. They cannot send them out. In our own country, a similar experiment has taken place in some areas in Kerala. So the same type of experiment is taken place in our country also, especially in Kerala. Ordinary people have participated in making a plan for the development of their locality. This new system of local government is the largest experiment in democracy conducted anywhere in the world. So this new system, that is local government, is the largest experiment in democracy. There are now about 36 lakh elected representatives in the panchayats and municipalities, etc., all over the country. Throughout in India, almost 36 lakh elected representatives are present in panchayats as well as the municipalities. This number is bigger than the population of many countries in the world. This member population is bigger than many countries of population in the world. Constitutional status for local government has helped to deepen democracy in our country. So according to our constitution, the local government is helped to deepen the democracy. That means the spread of the democracy in nook and corner of our country. It has also increased women's participation and voice in our democracy, because they allotted that reserved seats for the women. At the same time, there are many difficulties too. While elections are held regularly and enthusiastically, Gram Sabhas are not held regularly. While elections are held regularly, that means 5 years once that election are conducting, and then we are electing the ward members and panchayat head, and even in municipality members, councillors, we are electing. But the Gram Sabha meeting, that means per year, twice or 3 years they have to conduct, that are not held regularly. The meeting are not held regularly. Most state governments have not transferred significant powers to the local governments. So most of the state governments, they have not transferred, they are not give the significant, very important powers to the local governments. Nor have they given adequate resources. They are not allotting the funds, that is resources, by the state government to the local governments. We are thus, so according to this statement, we are thus still a long way have to go from realizing the ideal of self-government. So that's all your lesson. This lesson is completed. Thank you.